Welcome back to InvoDem Sessions. Today we are going to discuss about pharynx. Pharynx is a wide muscular structure which is present behind the nasal cavity, oral cavity and larynx. Coming to the boundaries of pharynx, superiorly it is bounded by base of the skull. This body of the sphenoid, posterior surface of the body of the sphenoid and base occiput. So these are the structures which forms the superior boundary of the pharynx. When comes to the inferior boundary of the pharynx, it is bounded by the cricoid cartilage and esophagus. Right? This is esophagus. Esophagus and cricoid cartilage. And inferiorly we can also see it is bounded by 6th cervical vertebrae, C6. So, 6th cervical vertebrae, cricoid cartilage and esophagus are the boundaries in the inferiorly. So, inferiorly the pharynx is bounded by these three components, superiorly by the base of the skull, that is body of posterior part of the body of the sphenoid and base occiput. So, these are the superior and inferior boundaries for the pharynx. Anteriorly, as we know, nasal cavity, oral cavity and larynx, right? And posteriorly, pharynx freely glides on prevertebral fascia. So, these are the general boundaries for the pharynx. When we go in detail, the pharynx is divided into nasopharynx, right? Oropharynx, laryngopharynx. So, nasopharynx, oropharynx and laryngopharynx. Today, we will discuss about nasopharynx. This part. So, we will discuss about nasopharynx. Nasopharynx is situated just behind the nasal cavity, above the soft palate, right? And the nasal cavity is respiratory in function. So, nasopharynx is also respiratory in function. It contains ciliated columnar epithelium. So, nasopharynx is lined by ciliated columnar epithelium. And when it comes to the boundaries of nasopharynx, the boundaries of nasopharynx, the wall of the nasopharynx is formed by one fascia and one ligament. What is the fascia name that comes to our brain when we think of pharynx? Pharyngobasilar fascia, right? So, pharyngobasilar fascia is the fascia which is present and forms the wall of the nasopharynx. And what is the ligament? So, we are discussing about pharynx. So, pharyngeal ligament. Prefix to that, posterior median pharyngeal ligament. So, these two components are forming the wall of the nasopharynx. What are those two? Pharyngobasilar fascia and posterior median pharyngeal ligament. Right? So, these are the two components which forms the wall of the nasopharynx. Anteriorly, the nasal cavity which is present, and inferiorly it is oropharynx and pharyngeal isthmus that is present. Isthmus is nothing but an opening between the two, nasopharynx and oropharynx. So, inferiorly oropharynx and pharyngeal isthmus. Anteriorly, it is again nasal cavity. Walls are formed by these two components. And coming to the lateral wall. Lateral wall is formed by, see, we all know there is something known as inferior nasal concha. So, this is inferior nasal concha. This inferior nasal concha, just behind 1.2 centimeters, there is something known as pharyngeal opening of auditory tube. So, this is pharyngeal opening of auditory tube, which is present, and there is a tubal elevation that is bounding this opening. So, the pharyngeal opening of the auditory tube is bounded by a tubal elevation, right? Just behind that tubal elevation, there is a vertical fold that runs down posteriorly from the tubal elevation. This is a vertical mucous membrane fold, which is named as salpingopharyngeal fold. Right? This is nothing but a mucous membrane fold which is running behind of the tubal elevation, runs posteriorly from the tubal elevations, go down and then it will become very slender. Just behind that salpingopharyngeal fold, there is a slit known as pharyngeal recess. So these are the lateral wall and there is a muzzle. So we are discussing about the lateral wall. So tell me a muzzle with L in this region, levator valley palatini. Right? So levator valley palatini is a muzzle which is present on the lateral wall, and these are the boundaries. When it comes to the roof, again, the roof of the nasal cavity is formed with the body of the sphenoid, basi occiput, and we can also find atlas, which is present here, right? Cervical vertebrae. This is the cervical vertebrae, which is known as atlas, which is present. So these all forms the posterior or the roof of the nasopharynx. So below the mucous membrane of the nasopharynx, there is the lymphoid aggregations. So these lymphoid aggregations are known as nasopharyngeal tonsils. So these tonsils are bigger in size in children, right? So these are bigger in size in children. When the humans grow and becomes adults, the size of the lymphoid tissue decreases and then it will perish, right? So during childhood, when the lymphoid system is very active, if there is any infection to this nasopharyngeal tonsils, the enlarged and infected nasopharyngeal tonsils are named and diagnosed as adenoids. So these are few points regarding the nasopharynx, and the nasopharynx is supplied by the pharyngeal branch of pterygopalatine ganglion. We are reading about pharynx, right? So pharyngeal branch of the ganglion, the good ganglion to our dentistry among four ganglions is a parasympathetic ganglion, that is pterygopalatine ganglion. So nasopharynx is supplied by the pharyngeal branch of pterygopalatine ganglion, suspended by the maxillary branch of trigeminal nerve. So these are the nervous supply and anatomy and the features of nasopharynx and boundaries of pharynx in general. So hope you have understood nasopharynx. See you in the next session. Take care. Stay motivated. Thank you so much.